Hi, my name's Rusty Payne. You may have heard about big food shortages coming in the future. Well, I hope they don't come, but in the meantime, partial food shortages are constantly driving up the price of vegetables. Since vegetables are actually the most important thing we eat, I just wanted to show you a few of mine. If you don't have a vegetable garden, you might consider putting one in. We live in Southwest Florida, so we plant in September and October for the winter. This is romaine lettuce, doing very nicely. Paris Island Coast. And this is the way broccoli looks when it's growing. See the broccolis, the florets coming up? There's nothing like fresh broccoli out of your own garden. Here's another one. This one we ate already. This is celery. It's hard to beat celery from your own garden. This is green cabbage. These are weeds. These plants here are cauliflower. They look a little stressed because we planted them in the shade. When we first built this garden and started building up the soil, it was before we built that big garage behind you. And so now it's in shade, but there will be cauliflower here. These are peppers. Little ones gonna get bigger. Up. Oh, didn't pick that one time. Hate to throw food away. At least I didn't pay for it. These are carrots. These are radishes. Radishes are the easiest things to grow. If you just want to start growing something, plant radishes. They'll grow really quickly. These are beets. Beets are an amazingly nutritious food. And the great thing about beets is that you can eat the greens. The greens are some of the best greens you can ever eat. Any kind of plant. Arugula and different kinds of lettuces. Butter leaf. More radishes over here. You can easily grow a lot more lettuce than you can possibly eat. This is bok choy. Wonderful vegetable. These are collard greens, powerhouse of a vegetable. More peppers. This beautiful plant here is a red cabbage. There's more broccoli. Kale, two kinds of kale, curly leaf and dinosaur kale. Of course, these are green onions. At least 6 months of the year, we never have to spend a penny on green onions. But my brother and my dad can eat about 12 of them at a sitting. These are bush beans. These are eggplants. They grew quite nicely down here. These are tomatoes. You know how much tomatoes cost in the store? A lot. Of course, growing your own tomatoes, you can also grow some of these strange, weird, or heirloom tomatoes that taste different. I've never seen these black tomatoes in a store. These plants with the huge leaves, mustard greens also, very nutritious. Here's another cabbage plant. See the head starting to form inside? Even if you don't have soil, if you don't have a yard, you can still grow these vegetables. This is a broccoli plant growing quite happily in a 30-gallon container. This is a passion fruit vine. There's a passion fruit growing on it. This is a black pepper plant. These will eventually become black peppers, black peppercorns. These are banana trees, or really banana plants. Here you can see the bananas growing on it. This is a dragon fruit plant. Produces a marvelous fruit. But you got to get the red ones, not the gray ones. This is our pineapple plantation. I need to plant these guys, speaking of planting. If you get a whole pineapple at a store, take the top and plant it. It'll grow a new pineapple in a year and a half. Of course, you can grow a lot of other things besides vegetables. We have a lot of fruit trees here on the Payne DeRosa, but I'm not talking about those now. But I'm just trying to encourage people to plant vegetables, because with about a half hour a day, you can maintain a garden. In the beginning, you're going to have to figure out what your soil needs, pull all the weeds out of the garden. But to maintain a weed-free garden doesn't take much more than a half hour a day. You might have to water it, you might have to weed it, but that's still just about a half hour a day. Certainly growing your own vegetables is worth the time and effort.